Hi. Today we have the CFO of Mindtree Limited with us, Mr. Pradip Menon. Thank you so much, sir, for taking time out of your busy schedule and sharing.
Thank you for inviting me.
Definitely, sir. Thank you so much for sharing your insights. So we just wanted to have a perspective about how, in your opinion, the IT industry right now is shaping up and how is Mindtree placed in that overall competitive scenario. So the first question that I would like to start with is, how do you see the overall IT industry, especially the Indian IT services companies, play out over the next couple of years? We've had a very difficult time over the past 2016 and 17, in which, of course, the new age digital technologies left us grappling at a lower than in single digit kind of growth. So do you think, but this year has been quite great in terms of deal flows, in terms of growth, Mindtree itself has reported great strong numbers. So do you expect this momentum to continue, and what are the kind of challenges that you foresee in the next coming years for the overall Indian IT industry?
Sure. So I think I would say that the Indian IT industry has been extremely, you know, adaptive to change. So if you look from the time that we've started as an industry, we've seen various waves. And at every stage, you know, it's been said that, you know, a doomsday has been predicted for the Indian IT industry. And every stage we have come out stronger. So I think we've also come out stronger as an industry, even in this new wave of digital offerings. And I believe Mindtree is very well positioned in that space. So if you look at us as a company, we have over 50% of our revenues coming through from the digital stream of work. We've also grown very well. We've almost grown 2x of the industry. Even if you look at various other parameters such as customer satisfaction scores or our ability to grow our Mindtree Minds, our employees, we've also maintained very low attrition levels. Overall, I think even from the various four verticals that we operate in, whether it is the banking, financial services and insurance sector, whether it is the RCM, the retail and manufacturing sector, or even the other verticals such as travel and hospitality, as well as the high-tech vertical. All the four verticals have grown well. We've also ended last year with a revenue of $1 billion, which is a tremendous achievement. One in 20,000 ideas really get to this point. So we're extremely well-positioned, both from a portfolio, customer, even from the employee perspective. So we are extremely positive. We've typically been growing 1.3, 1.4x of the industry growth. And we don't see anything changing going to into the new future as well.
Sure. Overall, for the industry also, do you see more challenges than basically opportunities? Or do you think what we did, what happened in 2016 and 17 was probably just a lull period, and now the overall industry is also all set for a very strong growth?
I think whatever I am picking up, like you, you know, reading, interacting with the various forums and gives me a lot of confidence, because there was a time when IT and digital was seen sort of at the back end or you know, the back office kind of work, but more intuitively I find that IT services as a offering is now in the CEO's agenda. It is more and more front end, more and more part of the business strategy, and all of this augurs well for the IT industry. And as I said again, for us also as a company, we are well positioned, because we believe that, you know, it must be about having an impact on the business, connecting better with our customers and with our customers and their employees. So I think all of that, I think augurs well, both for the industry and of course Mindtree being part of that group.
That's great to hear. So regarding Mindtree, I would again probably come back to specifically. Now Mindtree is a company for which, I don't know, but we have always used this term that Mindtree was born digital. We've always had very strong feedback about the company from different clients, different sources, that though smaller in size than the more celebrated large cap companies, Mindtree has always managed to carve a niche for itself. It's been really great in some specific segments. Overall, the customer feedback has been really great. And it's always been at the forefront of technology innovation. And we've seen that in this digital cycle as well. So I know it might be a little bit subjective question, but what basically propels Mindtree to be able to achieve this time and again? And do you see that advantage over your peers diminish or continue over the next maybe 3-5 years?
I'll give you a couple of perspectives. I think one is around the fact that the intuitive belief in the company, whether it is the top management, the founders, etc., has been that it is to make an impact, it is more about capability rather than capacity. And it is also about doing a few things right and in a very impactful manner, rather than trying to do everything. So from a very beginning, when the company was set up, we've not gone into BPO or any of those services which we don't believe we have the capability or niche. We don't say that's not a good business, but we don't believe we have that domain capability or understanding to really play in that space. So I think we've always believed in doing a few things and do that well. So that's the starting point. The second element here is that if you look even from the way we have trained our minds, the group which comes into our organization, we make sure that they are skilled at all stages in their career and they stay relevant, whether from an industry perspective or from their own personal goal perspective. So I think those two elements, A, the philosophy of doing few things right and also doing good with our employees, whom we call Mindtree Minds, that is one of the fundamental reasons why we always feel that we are sort of able to do this. Last but not the least is we believe in thinking ahead of the game. So even a few years back when digital was not so much of a cool thing, our current chairman and earlier CEO actually set out disproportionate on investments behind digital, saying that this is going to be the area where the maximum growth is going to come from. That has yielded us results, which is why we are today at a position where almost half of our business is coming from digital projects. I think similar thinking we have also going ahead. So we are already thinking what beyond digital. So how do we prepare for that world, and we are also making suitable investment in that space. I think that's one of the reasons why we are in a position to compete effectively with much larger players.
And you believe this advantage is probably going to continue? Very difficult for competitors to catch up, I suppose.
I think we can never be overconfident, right. But I think we always need to stay humble and stay relevant and keep at it, think ahead of the game. That's what we are currently also doing.
Sure. So regarding just small, let's say little bit of challenges that the industry is facing right now, I think one challenge that we've come to hear, of course, from different sources is about employees. So now with the digital wave coming in, you need more people who are not just trained to code in C++, Java, Python, but more in, let's say, who are in analytics, or let's say who are data scientists rather than just software engineers. There's a paucity of that kind of a talent. Also with H1B restrictions and other companies also becoming a little bit more conservative in terms of globalization. Do you foresee that as a challenge for the offshore model itself? So is that offshore? So I wouldn't call it under threat, but is offshore model facing those challenges? And if yes, then how is you think the industry could cope with it? And what is Mindtree doing to address it?
So I think on this offshore versus onshore, I think we've already crossed that bridge. So when I said that, at various points of time, the Indian IT industry has been written off. But this was one stage when it was said that it was doomsday for IT industry, that you have to have much more onshore offering because of various visa restrictions. But I think we have come out of that stronger as a overall industry, and as Mindtree, we have done our own bit to make sure that we are able to navigate in the new world, whether it is in terms of having the right talent pipeline onshore, having a pipeline coming from universities and other partnerships that we have on the ground. So I think we have positioned ourselves well from that perspective, and not necessarily get sort of dragged into this issue of onshore or offshore. So I think even with these challenges, I think we still see positivity going into the future, both for the industry and as well as Mindtree.
That's great to hear. So maybe I'll just end with one last question from my side. Mindtree has already reached double-digit growth, and they are doing much, as you said, 1.5 times industry average. The industry average right now is at around 6-7 or 6-8%. When do you think industry will be able to reach double-digit or catch up with Mindtree?
No, I think that's a great situation where the industry catches up with Mindtree, and Mindtree goes 1.3, 1.4x of that. I think that would be a very nice situation for all. I don't see any headroom or a challenge on growth or opportunities. I think there are enough and more opportunities. Increasingly, the Indian IT industry is being recognized globally, whether in the US or in other parts of the world, as adding value. And we are seeing some of the larger players from India actually coming and becoming one of the top players globally as well. So I think the Indian industry is growing faster, delivering value, and therefore I don't see any reason why the IT industry cannot grow faster, and obviously with whatever challenges we have to overcome them, and Mindtree even growing faster than what we've been doing so far.
Sure. Great, sir. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.